Hello friends, my name is Dahat PG and I am working here in RVNB College, Shrirampur, District Ahmednagar. We are looking at the chapter Semiconductor Devices, which is in a 12th standard. In previous lectures, we have seen what is the transistor and the types of the transistor. Transistor is nothing but the two diodes are joined back to back, which has the three electrodes, namely here is the symbol diagram of the transistor. The middle portion or the middle electrode is nothing but the base, this one. As compared to collector, emitter is small. This one is the emitter. If this is the PNP transistor, this one, this electrode is called as the collector, right? And the another block diagram of the type of the transistor is nothing but the NPN transistor. This one is the P region, this one is the N region, and this one is the P region. And another type of the transistor is the NPN transistor. The P-type semiconductor is switch between the two N types of materials, and this middle portion is nothing but the base, which is smaller in size and which is lightly doped as compared to the emitter. Emitter is moderately doped, and the collector region here, this one is the emitter and this one is the collector. This is the two types of the transistor. One is the PNP and another one is the NPN transistor. Now let us see the transistor configurations. This transistor is used in different configurations. As we know that there are the three electrodes, which is nothing but the emitter, collector and base. Hence this transistor can be used in three different configurations. Using these transistor configurations are in circuit. This transistor can be used in three types of the configuration. Let us talk about it. This transistor configuration, the first configuration is nothing but we can use it in a common base configuration, where the base is common, the base electrode is common in input and in the output circuit. Or next configuration is nothing but the common emitter configuration. Here the next configuration is the common emitter configuration, and the third configuration is nothing but the common collector configuration. Here the electrode, which is the collector, is connected in common. Let us see the diagram. First we will start with the common emitter. In this, the common emitter configuration, let us see the common emitter configuration. We have the three electrodes, 1 is the base one. This one is the collector and this one is the emitter. If this transistor is made up of the NPN transistor, then this arrow indicates the PN direction of this arrow indicates the PN direction, and this one is the base this one is the emitter and this one is the collector. This one is the base. Base and emitter and collector and emitter are grounded together in input. Input is given between the base and the emitter, between these two electrodes. If this is the NPN transistor, for the NPN transistor, this is the NPN transistor, and for another transistor PNP, the configuration of the another transistor, which is the PNP transistor, here this one is the base, this one is the collector, and this one is the emitter, and this arrow indicates the PN direction, and this is the transistor. Let us see, for collector this is for E and this one is the base. The input is given between the base and emitter, and output is taken between the collector and between these two electrodes, collector and the emitter. Emitter is common to the both. This configuration is called as the common emitter configuration. Now let us see about the next configuration, which is the common base configuration. Here base is connected in common to the other two electrodes. The next configuration is the common base configuration. In this configuration, the base electrode is, this one is the base which is connected to the common electrode and grounded together. This one is the base and this one is the emitter and this one is the collector. The arrow, if this arrow indicates the direction of PNP transistor, this one is the transistor, this is the emitter, and this one is the collector electrode of the transistor. This direction shows the PN direction, that means this transistor is the PNP transistor, and for the NPN transistor, here for NPN transistor, the common base configuration, let us draw it. Here is the base electrode connected in common. This is the B, this is the electrode emitter, and this one is the collector. The direction of the arrow is in the direction. This indicates that this is the NPN transistor, which is connected in the configuration of the base configuration. Here we see that base is connected to both the electrode. Here emitter and the base is connected and grounded in the input circuit, and here collector is connected with the base and grounded in the common base configuration. Now the remaining one is nothing but the common emitter. In common common collector, common collector is connected to remaining two electrodes and it is grounded. In common collector configuration, in this common collector configuration, the collector is here is the base and this one is the collector which is grounded, right? And this one is the emitter electrode, and the direction of the transistor PN direction is given by the arrow. This is the NPN transistor, where this electrode is nothing but this is the emitter, this is the collector, because collector is connected common to the base. This one is the base electrode. Collector is connected in between base and the emitter, and output is taken between this collector and the emitter. Input is given between this base and the collector. This is the this arrow indicates whether this transistor is NPN or the PNP. This transistor is the NPN transistor, and for the PNP transistor the similar connections are there, or configuration is similar. Base is here, this one is the base, this one is the emitter, and this one is the collector. Collector is connected to the both the electrodes, base and the emitter, and the input is given to the base to the collector, and output is taken between the emitter and the collector. Here this one is the PNP transistor, and this arrow shows the direction of the flow, and it also indicates the transistor, which one is the PNP and the NPN transistor. The most commonly used configuration is nothing but the common emitter configuration. Let us see the common emitter configuration using the circuit diagram. Here is the diagram of the common emitter configuration. Let us talk about the common emitter configuration. We know that the emitter current we get is nothing but the, it's a combination of IC plus IB. This is the input circuit in which is connected in the forward bias, and this is the output circuit which is connected in the reverse bias. The impedance, we get the maximum current in the input circuit because of its impedance is very low, and the we get the minimum current in the output circuit because its impedance is very high. The total current which we get is nothing but the IE is equal to IC plus IB. The total current which we get at the output is nothing but the IE plus IB. Here the beta is nothing but the output gain, or it is the beta is known as beta is nothing but the current amplification factor. This is the current amplification factor, or which is also called as the current gain, which is given by the is beta, which is in DC, which is also given by the IC upon the IB, current which we get at the output upon the input current, which is nothing but the IB. Similarly, the alpha is nothing but the input gain, alpha DC is nothing but the input gain, which is given by the IE upon IB. From these two equations, we come to know that this IC is equal to beta into IB is equal to alpha into IE. Now, the relation between these two gains is given by beta is nothing but the alpha upon the alpha minus 1, and this alpha is given by beta upon beta plus 1. The common emitter configuration is commonly used because of the performance, and the output amplification is maximum in this configuration. Whatever amplification is given in the output is the maximum as compared to the other configurations. Here the currents which are IC, IB and IE depends upon the configuration of the transistor, and if we change the input current IB, then we get the output sudden change in the output, or the output current which is IC. Even in the small change in the base current changes the output or changes the collector current, and the factors which are related to each other are here the current amplification factor beta is equal to alpha upon alpha minus 1, and this alpha is equal to beta upon beta plus 1. For the common emitter configuration, this current amplification factor beta DC is between 20 to beta DC is equal to between 20 to 200 in common emitter configuration. If we see, or if we say this beta is 100 for a particular common emitter configuration, then it means that a single electron will pass through this base when the 100 electrons will pass through the IC. This is about the common emitter configuration, and based on that this common emitter configuration is its characteristic is used in the transistor amplifier. This is all about the common emitter configuration. We will see the common emitter amplifier in later lectures.